Hi guys, good morning. Today we are going to discuss about the concept of alternative fuels. Okay, myself Dr. K. Arun Prasad. I am working as an assistant professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, BSN College of Engineering and Technology. Okay, fine. Now I am start to share my screen. Okay, I hope the screen is visible to you. Okay, so please listen the video. Okay, till the end, don't skip anything else. Then only you are able to understand the concept what I am trying to discuss with you. Okay, fine. So, what do you mean by alternative fuels? Okay, guys, already we are facing so many problems due to our environmental pollution and the scarcity of fossil fuels and everything. So, here the role of these alternative fuels is nowadays is very, very essential. Okay, first we are discuss some basics about these alternative fuels. Okay, where fuels where we are segregated into two types. One is conventional fuels, the other one is non-conventional fuels, otherwise renewable non-renewable. So the conventional fuels are the fuels where it's available in our earth crust, where we can make a dig and we can take these materials out. Obviously it's a material, okay, because it has that ability to work with some functional applications. So these are some materials. It has different forms like plastics, metals, non-metals, alloys, composite, ceramics. So many forms are there. All the forms are having different application, so we are utilizing these forms for separate functions. Okay, so guys, please listen. So the conventional energy sources are where we are, for example, we have coal, we have petrol, diesel, okay, we have tar. Okay, we just simply dig this thing from the air and we can use these things for our applications. But nowadays what happened, guys, due to the increasing of population, due to the increasing of newer technology and new systematic utilization of these energy resources, that there is the scarcity in for these conventional fuels. Okay, where these conventional fuels are non-renewable, because it is there inside our earth. Okay, for a lack of years ago, then we can utilize. Now everything is completed. Now there is no material to utilize. So what happened? People are stuck over here, because in the past 5 to 10 decades, people are working with these conventional fuels of discovering so many of automobiles, for example, cars, bikes with various ranges. But nowadays we are in this situation to meet that one, to find some another source. So this is the reality, guys. Then another set of energy sources is unconventional energy sources, okay, or renewable energy sources. So these renewable energy resources where we can create by our own. Okay, we can create by our own. For example, we are getting electricity through water, wind, geothermal. Okay, these are some possible ways of producing energy. So we won't need any external sources. Okay, it is available there in the earth. We can just simply stimulating that component. If I want to produce power from water, means just simply I need some flow of water. So these energy sources where I can use for many purposes. So these are some possible energy resources available, where conventional, non-conventional, everything. Nowadays, what is the next stage? So everything is there with us. Everything is there with us where we are utilizing these components for our applications. What is the next? The next era is, from this case, we are using some materials or some fuels for our applications. That fuel is called as alternate fuels. Simple example, nowadays what is the alternate for our normal petrol diesel is electric vehicle. People, they directly suggested about electric vehicle. But without going to that concept, because so many drawbacks there in the electric vehicle. What is the one of the best point is the lifetime of the batteries. The batteries won't support for us for more than 3 to 4 years. Okay, then another a valid point is where it doesn't have sufficient amount of horsepower or torque to pull more amount of weight. So these are some possible drawbacks. Whether the first point is valid one, where the lifetime of that battery must be higher. Okay, because we are investing more money to purchase that vehicle. Nowadays, we want to purchase an electric vehicle, the cost of the vehicle is around 80,000 to 1 lakh. The normal bikes what we are used in our regular activities, the price of that both bikes will be same. Then people, why they need that electric vehicle. So there is a research go on that to increase the life cycle of that batteries. So if possible, we are discussing about the hydrogen fuel cells type of energy resources in the some other videos where I can post on forthcoming days. So guys, please, today is where we are seeing about the concept of alternative fuels. The due to the said this thing in the starting of the video, due to the increasing of the energy consumption as well as the population, where we require some alternative sources. It's not an alternative energy. We require some sources because the current scenario, population is increasing, technology also developed. So what happened? All the things are purely depends upon the our normal fuels what we used conventionally. So the need for alternative fuels where to reduce the pollution, environmental pollution, where we need to preserve our earth against global warming. Then we also we need to maintain some economy ranges and some global demands. Okay, so here once we are using our fossil fuels, guys, where we are having the emission of pollution, it's obviously it's true. But from the BS standard, okay, where they are measuring the amount of using the these fossil fuels is day by year by year, every 5 year gap they just made a measurement. Okay, where that is called as Bharat stages. Now I think so we are in the sixth stage. Okay, so in earlier 1980s where they will started this concept of measuring the level of the pollutants, present in the atmosphere from the sources. What are the sources is there? Industries is one of the sources, then our automobile is one of the sources. Okay, the major sources are industries and automobiles, because these two contribute more amount of pollutant in our atmosphere. So day by day the industry is also growing. Day by day the number of users of these automobiles is also growing. So what happens finally, we are not able to maintain the level of pollutants in the atmosphere. Okay, so every 5 years once where they're going to measure the amount of pollutants like carbon monoxide, sulfur SOx gases, NOx gases, okay, and some other pollutants which present in the atmosphere in ppm, parts per million. Okay, then they will fix one target, guys. They will fix one target for next 5 years. If they are having that ability to reduce, or they are having that ability to achieve the target. If the target is achieved, simply this Bharat stage is moved to the next level, stage 7. You can take the history. Okay, we are having Bharat stage 4 up to 1, 2, 4. We are in the situation to reduce the percentage of pollutants present in the atmosphere. But what happens once in the after the Bharat stage 4 is completed, where we are not able to control the pollutants, so the 5 is not successful. So what happens, they directly move to the 6. So this is the reason here where they are not able to get the required amount of target, they are not reached. So once what happened, they are not reached, means the 5 is not successful. Then again they are redefined their targets based on some control measures they are taken. You people may aware of, you can hear some information from the news. In Delhi, where they won't allow the vehicles, all the vehicles go move to the roads. They can alternative, they will give some time, or alternative, they will give some date and something else based on some criteria. They will allow the vehicles to move in the roads. The reason is for reducing pollutants. Likewise, there's another important thing, our government also asks us to use some unleaded petrols and diesels for our vehicles, as well as they won't allow for fitness certificates for the vehicles more than 15 years, they move for the scrapping. So the government side, they are having some measures. So all of these measures are helps to achieve the next level of this Bharat stage. That is the concept, the next level of this Bharat stage. Okay, so people, as a human being, as a citizen of another country, we also look after this case, because obviously we are the persons who are affected due to this this kind of activities happens in our world. Okay, so this is some of the basic information about why we need these alternative fuels and what is the scenario of that Bharat stages there in our country. Okay, same things. Then another point I want to discuss with you is Akai number and Chitai number. What do you mean by Akai number? That is where this Akai number represents for gasolines like petrol and diesel. Then Chitai number, where we can use this word for diesel. Why we use this word Akai number, Chitai number? What do you mean by Akai number? Akai number and Chitai number, both the numbers measure the performance of the fuel. Okay, both the numbers measure the performance of the fuel. Due to the some circumstances where the diesel fuel shows some ignition delay. In the previous video, I discussed about some concept of combustion takes place in a diesel engine. So if we seen that video, you can understood why I have said the word ignition delay. Okay, so this ignition delay where it normally happens in our diesel engine. So for that we are measuring the performance of fuel based on the ignition delay. That number is called a Chitai number. Actually, the rate ranges between 60 to 100 for our normal gasolines. Then for our diesel, it ranges between 20 to 60. So this is the perfect range of our Akai and Chitai numbers, where we are giving these numbers for the to evaluate the performance of our both fossil fuels. Then another important concept is knocking. The same case, the knocking, if you want to understand what do you mean by knocking, knocking is a failure. Okay, it is knocking is a failure, where the performance failure then happens in the engine, inside the engine, where either the knocking may occurs due to the lack of air plus fuel mixture, then lack of time taken where the piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center, as well as this knocking happens due to the improper fuel performance. If the performance of the fuel is not good, the knocking will happen. So once the knocking is happened, what happened? Once that top portion of our piston and cylinder is completely damaged. So this Akai number and Chitai number denote the performance of the fuel. Based on these numbers, we can conclude whether our process going to be smooth or not. If something is there, some problem is there within these numbers, obviously what happened, the process what happens in the engine is completely going to be collapsed. Okay, so then some properties of fuel is there. Okay, we are directly enter into different types of alternatives. These are some alternative fuels, guys. One is ethanol and methanol, liquid petroleum gas, hydrogen, ammonia, CNG, LNG, then vegetable oil and biofuels. In this case, where we predominantly use LPG, okay, then CNG and LNG and some biofuels. The remaining things are is very difficult to generate, because these alternative fuels, guys, where we need to generate, and we have a separate setup to store this kind of alternative fuels in a separate tank, and from this tank we will look for some applications. So the main drawback of this alternative fuels is generation of these alternative fuels and this storage. So this both the thing is completely different while compared to our normal fossil fuels. That's why guys, till we are facing a problem to getting this. Okay, few people are to hear about that extraction of methane. Okay, where that methane extraction is also very difficult to extract it from our earth. Okay, but we can having that technology to store that methane for our application, but in that methane level will reduces the quality of the soil or quality of that land. Okay, so but in this case of alternative fuels, where we won't have those kind of issues, we can easily extract it. Here the methanol is mostly presented from a natural gas, okay, where we can entirely we can see that agricultural sources like sugar grains, then other topic of we can get this ethanol easily. Okay, where ethanol is simply is nothing but alcohol. Okay, the alcohol we have basing the based on the percentage of mixtures of blending gasolines. Okay, from the volume 5% to 10%, okay, or 10% and above, based on the mixing blends, this is classified into two categories. One is ethanol, another one is methanol. Okay, so the ethanol is 90% of ethanol and 5% of water. Where in till now in Brazil, USA, people they are very good approachment on this area of using this ethanol as an fuel in their vehicle, and also their government also supports for the people to using this ethanol in the vehicles. Okay, then methanol similar to our ethanol. Methanol is also one kind of fuel where the blending ratio may vary, guys. The blending ratio here may vary. So based on their blending ratio, we can fix it for the engines. Okay, so the main positives of this ethanol will compare to methanol, where it's an renewable energy resources, where it has the negative impact for that properties. Okay, where normally ethanol people they are preferring for our drinking beverages in wine. Okay, where there are some of the automobiles is also entirely run with ethanol. So the ethanol type of vehicles is first introduced in the world by Fiat in the year 1978. Okay, then how we can produce this ethanol and ethanol, both are by means of that fermentation process and blending of some amount of gasolines here. Okay, where these biofuels is not a pure form. Please understood, guys. These fuels are not a pure form, where we can blending these two liquids, either 5% of petrol with 85% of ethanol, or 50% of ethanol with 50% of the petrol. Likewise, we just mix blending together and we will follow the concept. Okay, so here the graph shows where United States they are using this kind of ethanol and methanol fuel vehicle. Brazil, China, India were ranking 7 usage of this this kind of fossil alternative fuels from the year 2009. Okay, but after 2009, okay, there is no possibilities there in our country in this usage of this kind of fuel. That's why, guys, where we are lacking. Okay, that's why guys we are lacking. Here they will show the process of extracting this ethanol from that places. Okay, where this diagram is clearly shows where we are having the methanol. Okay, we are having this methanol in all these areas. The possible extraction from agriculture resources only, guys, through fermentation process. That's right. Okay, there's don't confuse it in that. The possible extraction is from our agriculture resources through fermentation process. Then LPG, liquid petroleum gas. Okay, where is nothing but an a compressed gas where we can keep this gas in a cryogenic condition. Okay, well, you can know these properties of the this gas. Once we are once this gas is come to the atmosphere, where it will converted into gas. Once it's in the container, it is in a liquid. Okay, so most of this application of this this liquid petroleum gas only in the storage of cooking, as well as we can having some of the LPGs like chlorofluorocarbon in that refrigeration purposes. Okay, obviously this is environmental pollutant where we won't use this chlorofluorocarbon for our refrigeration purposes. Obviously, once we are compressed this gas CFC, is obviously it can create some human issues. But whatever may be, we need some alternative fuels where LPG is very useful for us day by day, where we are using all the types of industry, processing industry, metal processing industry, okay, textiles, okay, so in the dyeing industry, or wherever possible, we are using this LPG as an fuels. Okay. Then another fuel is hydrogen. Hydrogen fuel cells. Similarly, people there got hydrogen fuel cells. By means of the reaction of the hydrogen, just simply splitting that hydrogen from the water, then from the hydrogen, we just use that hydrogen for the process of producing power. Okay, there's a separate process is available where that process is called as thermolysis and electrolysis process. But most of the people in hydrogen fuel cells, they are preferred electrolysis process. It's very easy to separate that oxygen hydrogen molecules. From that separation, where we are producing some electric current, okay, and from this electric current, we just simply run the vehicle. Okay, this is the simple concept of our hydrogen fuel cells. That is called hydrogen fuel cells. Nowadays, the electrochemical process where they are having a mixed component of electro plus chemical process to make the environmental eco-friendly by creating deuterium is a heavy hydrogen isotope. Where these isotopes have the power which equal to the nuclear reactor, what we get that power, both are same. So this is one of the higher range of hydrogen atoms where we are used for the fuel cells in this term. So use of weather balloons where we have applications of this hydrogen, okay, where this hydrogen is very, very lighter and it helps to float that components or it helps to float the product where we are using for the application purpose. And some of the industrial applications like food preservatives, chemical industries, then vegetable preservatives, oils, then petrochemical industry. Okay, all the areas we are having the application of this hydrogen, as well as the one of the important thing where this hydrogen is one of the very good gas which helps to control the pest. Okay. So the next alternative fuel is ammonia. Ammonia is colorless and odorless gas. Okay, where we have this ammonia in our human body, as well as we are seeing this ammonia from water, soil, air, in the form of small molecules bacteria. Okay, then this ammonia is an ion where we can create this ammonia through metamolecules. Mostly this ammonia can support for our agricultural related products for sustainable production. So of crops, okay, those things people may aware of. So we can use this ammonia for our day-to-day activities other than the fuels for cleaning purposes, as well as we can generate some of the vegetable oils for our cooking issues also. Then industrial manufacturers where the ammonia helps to purify the water, as well as we have many products making like plastics, explosives, fabrics, pesticides and dyes. Okay, they are preferred ammonia for the one are considered ammonia for the main application as an alternative fuels for the paramedicals also. Okay, so fertilizer industries, metal grading industries, then in the cosmetic manufacturing industries, printing industries, okay, rubber industry, food and beverage, leather industry, in all the area they are using this ammonia for some other applications. Because while we're discussing the application of the alternative fuel, it took more time, guys. That's why I'm skipping this one. Okay, today we just orally we can discuss the basics about the alternative fuel. And then next one is CNG and SCF. CNG is nothing but conventional natural gas, where we just simply extract this natural gas from the atmosphere. Okay, yeah, and we can compress this one in 3600 psi. Then in place of gasoline or diesel, we just pop this case. One of the best example for CNG is where people are heard about Sandero Zing, okay, 2008 or 7 model. It is nowadays also Sandero, Hyundai Sandero, they have the facility for dual connection. Okay, only the petrol engine is possible for this to support for the dual connection. Diesel not at all possible. In the case of diesel, where diesel engine we can remove that setup, we can use only for that CNG for that driving purposes. Okay, so yeah, even though we can use for heavy trucks also, nowadays people they are preferring the CNG in automotives very higher. Okay, then liquefied petroleum gas, LPG, we already discussed. Okay, So when compared to CNG and LPG, where we need to look out this combustion ratio, because this combustion ratio is the point where responsible for the combustion process takes place in the engine. Okay, where we need to burn 1 kilogram of this CNG, we require 10 gram of this the same. Whether we are going to burn 1 gram of this LPG, we require 25% of it. Okay, so we how much output we are extracted, or once the how much input we are giving based on the output we are extracted. Okay, here the input of the compression is very, very less. So the combustion what we get in the form of in output is also very, very low when compared to this. That's why guys, where people they are preferring LPG more than CNG. And then based on the availability, extraction process, everything is very, very simple for LPG when compared to CNG. Okay, so most of that applications where people they are not focusing on CNG more than LPG. Okay, so the next concept is converters. Guys, where people may know that Rudolf Diesel, who is the father of discovering of this diesel engine concept. Okay, once the diesel engine is discovered, people they are look for the concept of alternative fuel. They just simply by means of adding some other components like vegetable oils, okay, then some other glycerin, okay, to develop the biodiesel. But nowadays we are having so many biodiesel engines is also available. Okay, based on the mixing ratio what we preferred, the blending ratio what we preferred, in the amount of our normal diesel plus our biodiesel based oils, glycerin, we can having some advantages. But the main point is the mixing ratio we need to keep constant for throughout the process. Once any delayed or something happens to the mixing ratio, okay, the engine does not work properly. That is the main drawback of this biodiesel engines. Okay, we need to maintain a constant mixing ratio. But everything is very good only once the output, once the mixing ratio, everything is fixed. The output from the these concepts of this biodiesel is very, very good. We are seeing very good results by the emissions of this carbon monoxide, okay, then hydrocarbons and SOx and NOx, then particulate emissions are very, very less when compared to our normal diesels. Okay, that's why people they are preferring biodiesels for vehicles. Okay, then this biodiesel is environmental friendly, where this doesn't show that much of environmental effect like our normal fossil fuels. That's also one of the reason why people they are preferring this biodiesel. So nowadays guys, where the increasing of pollutant content completely ruled out our environment. So in this stage to preserve our world, we are in the stage to preserve our world, where we are failed to preserve what happens means in our has to come to here in the world after our life is end is completely. So they doesn't have a piece of water, air, clean air to breathe. So they are searching waters and everything. So we are in the situation to preserve our natural actions, because we are the persons who distract the naturally happen things, so many things. That's why we are doesn't have the ability to judge the climatic condition even though. In the earlier days, they are simply set the month. This month, yeah, we have rain. This much we are having summer. So nowadays, we are not in the past 2 to 3 years, we are not in the situation to judge the climatic condition. What is the reason is that we are the responsibles by means of technological development for discovering of new technology components and everything. Okay, we just completely forgot the nature. So the nature won't preserve us. They also try to produce more amount of distraction for our living environment. So guys, so as an engineer or as a human being, we also having that responsibilities to keep everything safe. Okay, we are using to please reduce the usage of plastics. Okay, please use reducing the usage of vehicles. Have your walk. Okay, it's good for our health. Okay, don't look for another vehicle to travel from one place to another. Its distance is very less. Okay, have your walk. Otherwise, if you want to 3 to 4 persons are travel the same place with single vehicle, if this single vehicle reduces the emission of this toxic gases to the atmosphere. So all the things are there, all the happenings are in our hand only, guys. So as an human being, okay, as a citizen of another country, we need to maintain everything very clear. So that is the end of the today's video. Then again, if you have any doubt about this video, okay, you can please give your doubts in the comment box. I will reply. Please see this video till the end. Don't skip this video. It will have so many useful information about what we are having nowadays, what we are facing nowadays, and what is happening nowadays. Okay, thank you, guys. Thank you. We will meet you on the next video.